Welcome to my talk about super secret plasma features. Oculus didn't have a super secret SVG badge, so that's why it says top secret here. This talk is about some of the features in plasma that you may not know that are completely non-discoverable. You only know if you know the source code in and out, like our plasma developers such as me do. And it also shows you a bunch of things that if you know them, would question how you could use a computer or plasma without them. So first of all, if there's a talk I give about, it has to include something about notifications, and I talk about this feature a lot. But if you take a screenshot in Plasma, you get this little notification, and then you can actually drag and drop out the resulting screenshot and drag it to your email composer, your chat program, your ticket system, a GitHub merge request, or wherever you need it. So you just do meta shift print screen, select the region, and done, and then drag it over to wherever you need it. That's by far my favorite Plasma feature. It makes me so much more productive. And because I like the dragging thing so much, in 5.18 or 19, I added a little proxy icon for those who know macOS. If you download a file and you have Plasma browser integration installed, which you should, then you get a little Plasma notification when it finishes. And on there, you can then drag the file you just downloaded to wherever you need it. For instance, you downloaded some log file, you can drag it into Emacs and then look at it. Also, the menu has some additional actions there, like open containing folder or share to online service. If you just downloaded some file, you can then share it over to Imgur or Pastebin or something like that. And that's actually slightly more discoverable because there's actually a menu button you can click to open the menu, but it's still a right-click context menu, and it's something you have to be aware of. Then the more commonly known things are that System Tray has many little mouse and special mouse buttons you can click. So for instance, I think the most common one is that people know that if you mouse wheel the volume icon, you can change the volume. And if you middle click, you can toggle mute. And also in the pop-up, you can drag and drop applications to change output devices. But because nobody understood that, there's now a menu where you can click and reassign the output device. Also, the microphone indicator has the same feature. If you middle click it, you can toggle your microphone on and off. And it's interesting, this microphone indicator was done as part of the Plasma Privacy Go sprint and turned out really useful for like Corona when you're at home and doing online conferencing. You don't have to deal with like different conferencing solutions or you are now muted all the time in big blue button. You just middle click the volume icon on your panel. The battery icon also has a bunch of features. If you mouse wheel it, you can change the brightness. And that's actually one of those features that came from my laziness. Like all of those features are just for me being lazy. For instance, imagine you have your laptop on your sofa and you're just out of reach of your keyboard. And if you want to change the brightness, you would have to like press Fn and some weird combination to change the brightness. But your touchpad or your external mouse might be on your lap, and then you can just mouse wheel the battery icon. You can also configure it to show the percentage on the icon. It's disabled by default because I think it doesn't look very pretty, but it's there if you want it. Then also in Plasma 5.20, and it's something I don't know why I didn't add it earlier, but because at work I have 5.19 and I wish I had that feature already, because when doing screen sharing, I want to turn off notifications. So in 5.20, you can also middle click the notification icon to toggle Do Not Disturb mode, and then you don't have to select like 1 hour or 4 hours to just middle click it and off your notifications go. Plasma Network Manager also allows you to create a QR code from the Wi-Fi network. So if you have friends over, I mean, you shouldn't right now, but once you're able to have friends over again, then you can just share the Wi-Fi code via QR code, have them scan it, and then they're on your network. So Media Controller is also another of my favorites. It's the one icon that shows up in your panel when you play video and things like that. It also has a million hidden features that I think nobody but me knows because I added them just randomly. And so you can also middle click to play and pause the player, use the wheel to adjust just the player volume. And then also, if your mouse has back and forward keys for like browser navigation, you can use those to change tracks. So you can just go to the next track by using the next button on the media controller in the panel. And if you have the pop-up open, then you can also use stuff like press the number 3, and then it seeks to like 30% of the track. So you can like replay the same sequence all the time. And of course, there's global shortcuts. If the player is Empress enabled, like VLC player and also all of the other players, then your media keys on your keyboard, they will magically just work. And of course, if you have Plasma browser integration, then it also works for websites. So if you have YouTube or some other web-based player running, you can use media controller to control the player, pause, seek, forward, and do things like that. And then also one feature I implemented back when I built this thing is that you can bring the player to the front. I think, for example, VLC player doesn't do it, but now I know this with Big Blue Button because I often lose my Big Blue Button conferencing tab in the million tabs I've opened. And because Big Blue Button is just an HTML5 video stream, from what I can tell, you right-click on the media controller, you click on open, and then it brings you right back to the active Big Blue Button conferencing tab. So that's also a very unintended useful side effect. And then, of course, if you have KD Connect, you can control your players from your phone, and it even pauses when you get a phone call, and it's super, super handy. Still a bit freaking me out if you watch a YouTube video full screen and then like a phone call comes in and then your video pauses magically and then your phone starts to ring. It's like a bit eerie. Task Manager, it's the one that shows your windows on your panel. So if you're a Windows user, you might find the naming confusing. So for example, middle clicking on Windows in the taskbar, you can configure it to do all kinds of things. I personally use a close window. So it's like in a browser, I middle click a window, it goes away. By default, I think we now do open new instance for middle clicking. And then you can also do like bring it to the current virtual desktops. You can use the mouse wheel to change between windows. And then also you can use back and forward browser buttons on a player window. So if you have a VLC player window in your panel, you can use browser back and forward mouse buttons on that window entry in your panel to change tracks, because that is a much bigger hit target than the tiny media controller player icon in your tray. So you can just targets bigger VLC player window in your panel and use the buttons there. Maybe I should also add a feature to middle click pause or something like that. I don't know. Or mute. KRunner, I think most of you know, but still you open it by Alt Space, Meta Space, Alt F2, some weird MacBook button combination. It can convert units. You can drag and drop results. So most of these tips are like dragging things and obscure mouse button features. If you find a file in KRunner, you can drag it to your desktop or to your whatever application you wanted to open it. And then web shortcuts, you can configure different web shortcuts. They come from Conqueror, but you can like open Buxilla and things like that. So yeah, you type, or I used to type like FabD1234, and then when we were still like heavy on Fabricator, we could I could just jump to a Fabricator ticket. You can also change it to use a space instead of colon. And then there's a bunch of other things. There's Clipper actions, which I don't know what it does. I believe you can configure Clipper to offer certain actions based on what kind of regular expression the text you just copied matches in your clipboard or something. There's middle click paste, I think also most of you know, but if you select text somewhere, you can then paste it somewhere else by middle clicking. And if you do that on a desktop, it creates a sticky note for you. And actually in the early days, it would also do that on the panel, and then people would like accidentally middle click the panel and get like sticky notes and didn't know how to get rid of them. So nowadays it only adds sticky notes on your desktop, and you can disable that if you don't like that. Folders on a desktop are also spring loaded. If you drag a file over a folder, wait for a bit, then it opens the folder in a pop-up, and then you can drag the file in it, and then you can go like five folders down and open like a cascading pop-up list. If you drop an image on a desktop, it creates an image frame like this lovely group photo down there, or you can set it as a wallpaper. And we also have night color support in Plasma these days in Quinn, so that since 5.18, it can automatically reduce the amount of blue light on your screen for like better night hacking. Yeah, I think that's it. So that's those are a bunch of Plasma features you now know exist and can make you more productive. So thank you. And I guess that was the last track for this morning, and enjoy your lunch break.